In this video, we will take a look at the characteristics and presentation of cervicogenic headache.
Get our very own assessment ebook and mobile app. Links are in the video description.
Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. Headaches can manifest on their own, but are also a very common symptom in neck pain patients, as more than 60% of patients with a primary neck pain complaint report of having concordant episodes of headache. Therefore, it's essential to find out what kind of headache the patient is suffering from. To start off, let's differentiate between primary and secondary types of headaches. But what does that mean? Simply put, primary headaches are a disease themselves, whereas in secondary headaches, the headache is a symptom of another condition. So, primary headaches would be migraines, tension-type headaches, and cluster headaches. Secondary-type headaches are headaches caused by tumors, hemorrhage, other trauma, TMJ dysfunction, substance overdose, or neck pain, aka the cervicogenic headache. Now let's take a closer look at cervicogenic headache, which is a secondary type of headache. Cervicogenic headache has a prevalence of 0.17 to 4%, and as the name suggests, it is a headache caused by a disorder involving the cervical spine and its bony, disc, and/or soft tissue elements, and it is usually, but not invariably, accompanied by neck pain. In order for a headache to qualify as cervicogenic headache, it has to fulfill certain criteria. First and foremost, there will be clinical, laboratory, and/or imaging evidence of a disorder or lesion in the cervical region known to be able to cause headache, such as, for example, the facet joints or certain muscles. Furthermore, at least two of the following criteria have to apply. 1. The headache has developed after the onset of the cervical disorder or lesion. So, during your patient history taking, patients will probably describe a trauma. 2. The headache improves or resolves in parallel with improvement in or resolution of the cervical disorder or lesion. 3. Cervical range of motion is reduced, the pain is movement and posture dependent, and headache is made significantly worse by provocative testing, for example, decreased upper cervical spine rotation, as assessed by the flexion rotation test, can be linked to cervicogenic headache. You can watch this assessment by a click on the info icon in the top right corner. And 4, the headache is abolished after diagnostic blockade of a cervical structure or its nerve supply. Tools you can use to assess the impact of a headache on your patient are the HIT-6 questionnaire, which you can find in the video description down below. Also note that it can be difficult for a patient to answer all the questions on duration, intensity, and characteristics of their headache during your assessment. Therefore, asking them to complete something like a headache diary can help in the assessment and management of the headache, and you should be aware that there can be an overlap between multiple headache disorders. Okay, in the intro I mentioned that headaches are quite often associated with neck pain, so be sure to click on our neck pain guideline playlist on the left. Please check the links in the video description down below to learn more about ways to support us, such as our ebook, app, or online course. And as always, this was Andreas from Physiotutors. I'll see you next time. Bye.